I don't know if you would have guessed this by now, but I do like a good puzzle. So I like a good puzzle, but I don't always stick to English. And why not take the opportunity, if you're an avid language learner like myself, to do puzzles in different languages? So I'm going to walk you through some of my puzzle book collection. So I went to Croatia a few years ago and I bought this word search puzzle. Actually, I'm not really a great fan of word searches, but because it's in Croatian, I just had to buy it. So I bought actually quite a few of these, and I haven't done this one yet, but I'm not learning Croatian at the moment. So this is blank, but you can see the puzzles are themed. So for example, what's this one? Hrvatski is all about Croatia itself, and all these vocabulary here are ways to learn new words to incorporate new vocabulary into your language. So I think word searches are okay. I've got some Spanish poetry kit. So you can buy these in different languages, and they have little pieces of words that are magnetic. So you can put them on your fridge. You can make poetry from these. So have a bank of words here. So for example, as these are magnetic, they're going to stay, aren't they? Hopefully, they're not going to all fall off. I'll pick some out randomly and let's make a sentence out of them. Okay, so I've picked a few words out. So, madre, mundo, noche, and then some more here. Piedra, antes, and then there's a just the letter S, so you can pluralize something. So these are good fun. There's hundreds of little words here, and you could just cut them up and make a poem or write a little message for somebody. That's quite good fun. Right, next I've got a Polish workbook. So these aren't really puzzle books as such, but I tend to treat them as puzzle books because sometimes they have little crosswords or games in them, and it makes it more fun to learn a language when you're doing quizzes and exercises. So don't see them as exercises, see them as fun. Spanish crossword book, easy Spanish crossword puzzles. So these are quite easy actually. I've done a few of these already, and I know I'm not supposed to be learning Spanish, or am I? Well, I learned Spanish quite a long time ago, and I've got a confession to make. I just had two Spanish lessons this week, in the last week, and it was with a Colombian guy who teaches Hungarian. So I don't know how I came across him, but I saw him on italki and just decided to have a lesson with him to see how my Spanish was. It was just like a conversational thing, really, more of a practice than anything. And I ended up just speaking Spanish with him for an hour, which I was really pleased about. I mean, my Spanish isn't brilliant, but I managed to just speak in Spanish the whole time with a few Italian words thrown in. And I ended up having another lesson with him today. And I asked him, is my Spanish good enough to learn Hungarian with you? It's a bit greedy, isn't it? And he said, I think so. I don't know really. So tomorrow I've got another lesson with him, and I'm going to try to learn some Hungarian, which I've already learned some Hungarian a few years ago, but I didn't really learn much. So be interesting to see what happens there. Flesh. Ah! I didn't think of saying that before. It's just an impulsive thing I just did, like the Flash Gordon song. This is a book I bought in France, and it's one of these cross stick books. It's taken me quite a few months, I mean probably like months and months, to actually complete one puzzle. These are quite tough actually, But the good thing about these is that in the back you have a list of vocabulary. So here are all the possible answers in letter size, in word size. So you could go through and if you're stuck on something and you've got a couple of letters already there, especially like the first letters, so you've got a six letter word beginning with A, then you can look through this whole list and pick out the word. And by doing this, you'll probably learn a few words here. You might think, oh, I don't know what this one means or this one. Actually, I don't know what many of them mean, but that's another story. Right, so I have all those books and puzzle books, and I think doing puzzles is a good way to, it's just a break away from doing the boring exercises that you might do or the apps that you might use. It's just something different to do and another idea to learn languages. There are some online games you can play. So I play a game called, I've actually forgotten what it's called, but here it is, Quiz Planet. I probably do too many quizzes and that's probably why I forget. So you can play Quiz Planet in so many different languages. And one day I thought, I'm just going to try and play this in a different language. So I've got a French friend who used to be one of the students in my shop where I work, and he moved back to France. So he speaks French, obviously. So I thought one day I'm just going to change the language on this quiz game to French and see if I can beat him. I'm not very competitive, really. Okay, I am a bit. So I changed the language to French, and we've just stuck with French ever since. So I've played quite a few games with him. The only problem is when it comes to questions like history or politics, it tends to be from a French perspective. So my French history isn't brilliant, but you know, it's a great way to sort of learn more new vocabulary in a language. And I play with a Swedish friend as well. So I've used to work with a Swedish friend years ago. I worked with her for many years. Her English is like impeccable. It's like C2 level. And she also speaks German. And I decided to play a quiz game with her and change the language to Swedish. So I don't actually know Swedish. I learned some phrases. I've got some Swedish things here. Like I've got this. And a few other Swedish things that I went through, but I can't say that I know anything more than basic Swedish. But I try and play Quiz Planet with her, and I invariably lose, but I've just actually beat her today, so I'm quite pleased with that, because some of the questions I did actually know, and I'm learning a few extra words as we go along. So that's good. Now, there's another quiz game you can play online, which is called Word... See, I've forgotten what it's called again. I only can remember them from what they look like visually. Anyway, it's a word game, and you can... It's a bit like Boggle, I think, where you have letters and you can click through like a snake to see if you can find the longest word. And I've played this in Polish with a few Polish friends I've got on Facebook. So here's a screenshot of that. So these are just some daft ideas if you want to do them for learning language. It's just something fun you can do, and if you're playing these games anyway online, why not just play them in a different language? I forgot to mention in this Spanish book that the first few puzzles are in English and Spanish. So you have the question is in English and the answer goes in Spanish, and then later on it's in Spanish and Spanish. So it's like how you would get an easy crossword in that particular language. In the back of this book, there's quite a good vocabulary. So it's more like a dictionary, really. So it's all the words that you'll find in this crossword are in this vocabulary, and the answers are here as well. So you can cheat. I wouldn't do that, actually. I wouldn't cheat. I wouldn't.